In the person of Dr. Timothy Harris, a man who everybody says any ministry he does, he makes sure the ministry moves. He makes sure the ministry works. And he goes to show that when all the other countries in the OECS reported a deficit, St. Kitts and Nevis reported a surplus of well over $80 million. And that is because you have a man like Dr. Timothy Harris in your hands. And so when the people of PAM put up the poster and talk about the changes happening here, there and everywhere, all of them still reporting a deficit. And since no change happened here, we reported a surplus. And it happened with Dr. Timothy Harris. Name of the KFC and the tax. You would have to ask him when he comes to the microphone. Nonetheless, Dr. Timothy Harris is a good man. And every time I get the opportunity to sit in a meeting with Dr. Timothy Harris, he's always rooting for the people of constituency number 7. He'll never stop rooting for the people of number 7 yet. Every time I sit down, the man wants something for number 7. But don't worry, it's all in the interest of you. And that is why you have a good leader. And with the kind of licks that Timothy Harris does share in this constituency, you know, I can't figure out why somebody would want to come against him. Nobody could have paid me no amount of money to call them loads. So I can't figure out who run come said the war against Dr. Timothy Harris. Not with the kind of loads that they show in this constituency. It got to be he got something personally against Dr. Harris. But let me tell you people something here. Let me tell you something tonight. The People's Action Movement have been campaigning. And they're basically been campaigning against St. Kitts and Nevis, you know. They're not campaigning against Labour, you know. They're campaigning against St. Kitts and Nevis. Because they're out in the international community saying St. Kitts want help. And that Tories should not come to St. Kitts. And they very well know that this economy currently depends on tourism. And so when they're out there telling the international community that St. Kitts is not a good place for tourists to come, let them remember that whether you're PAM or you're Labour, when the tourists come, you're out of a job. A whole lot of families going to suffer because we depend on tourism. Labour made sure that when we were developing, when we were diversifying the economy, tourism has been playing a very important role. And so PAM is now out there campaigning against that. And that is the kind of people who say they want to come back and run this country. They obviously don't care about the people in this country. They don't care about the hundreds of families working in the tourism industry. They care about themselves. These people are after the lands. These people don't care about me, they don't care about you. And so they would say and do anything just to get in power. But you know better. You the people of constituencies have no better. You the people of this entire country know better. Because Labour has been good to this country. Labour is good. And all the time, Labour is good. And Labour will continue to be good. Because Labour cares for you. And Labour cares for me. Labour cares about all of us. And that is why this party is going to stand here in the next general election. This party is going to take home the next general election. And by the way, number 5 coming with it now. Number 5 coming this time. Because down there, number 5, the man of panic. He in a great panic, a great deal of panic. He running round and round the constituency like a chicken without a head. He alone up and down with a loudspeaker in the car. He must see Reggie. I don't understand. Nobody wants to drive in the car with him. Because nobody up on the foolishness. People get fed up on the nonsense. All he do is complain. When you elect somebody to lead you, you need that person to show you proper representation and real leadership. And that is what you have in Timothy Harris. And that is what you have in this entire team. But rather than that, all he does is complain like a little child. Complain, complain, and blame everybody. Blame everybody for what he has not been able to accomplish. But I wouldn't have to blame anybody. I know what I have to do. I know what I have to do for the people of number 5. And I have had great teachers. And I continue to learn. I look at Dr. Timothy Harris, and he's a very, very good example. Because when I speak to people anywhere around this country, they tell me, Timothy Harris is a good man. Timothy Harris is a good man. And if they were living, even Pam people telling me, if they were living in number 7, they would have voted for Harris. And that is why we know Harris again. Harris again. No matter where you're going, number 7, it's Harris again. And don't worry about it. Recently I've been visiting the community of Halfway Tree. And I took note of something very important. I realized that there are now 26 new houses built by this Labour Party government right there in Halfway Tree. And when I inquired, I found out that the lands on which these houses are built, it belonged to Lindsey Grant. Imagine one man own all of the land for himself, and now the Labour Party government would put 26 families on that land, the land that one man occupied. And they didn't mean that Macaulay lands, you know. Lands, this is what the election is about for Lindsey Grant and his gang. Lands. And everybody in this country knows it. Lindsey Grant and his gang, they're after the land. But Lindsey, he's not a good leader. He's not a good leader, and that is why he can never muster up a following like this. No matter where they're going in this country to give a meeting, they can't put a gathering like this. Labour have a massive gathering. Labour have a massive following. No matter where you're turning in this country. And Pam can't do that.